I came here and protected the animals as best I could. In fact, I'm the only protection for these animals out here.
2005, smack dab in the middle of the new millennium, the year finally brought us the future we were promised. Flying cars, laser guns, and human beings mingling with alien species. Or maybe that was just in the movies.
You think you've got problems?
Okay, so maybe 2005 didn't take humanity to a real-life galaxy far, far away.
Together, you and I can rule the galaxy.
It did, however, bring the world all sorts of thrilling events. The year was jam-packed with pop culture touchstones, from the premieres of iconic sitcoms to the release of genre-defining albums. The internet was abound with new and exciting websites, and civil rights were progressing in a big way. But it wasn't all sunshine and rainbows behind these hazel eyes in the year 2005. Natural disasters and terrorists took the lives of thousands across the globe, and over 4 million people traveled to the Vatican to mourn the passing of a pope. And through it all, we were collectively watching to see whether Jim was finally going to tell Pam how he felt. Today, we're going to talk about the news, culture, sports, entertainment, and all that was weird in 2005. This is Timeline. All right, we're taking you to the candy shop because this is 2005. But before we get started, be sure to subscribe to the Weird History Channel and let us know in the comments below what other mid-2000s memories you hold dear. Now, do you feel God in this Chili's tonight? The year started off with a triumph over a tragedy that occurred 4 decades earlier. American Ku Klux Klan organizer Edgar Ray Killen was arrested for the murders of 3 civil rights workers. The crimes, which occurred in 1964, were a high-profile event at the time, but several of the men involved, including Killen, escaped punishment. The victims, James Chaney, Michael Schwerner, and Andrew Goodman, finally saw justice when Killen was convicted in 2005 and sentenced to 60 years in the Mississippi State Penitentiary. However, he would not serve his full sentence. In January of 2018, Edgar Ray Killen passed away at the age of 92. Killen had only served around 13 years in prison, which is less than a quarter of his 60-year sentence. Just 20 days later, Condoleezza Rice was sworn in as the U.S. Secretary of State, making her the first African-American woman to hold the position in the history of the country.
Colin Powell leaves big shoes to fill at the State Department. Condi Rice is the right person to fill them.
Now it's time to build on those achievements to make the world safer and even more free.
After earning several advanced degrees in political science, Dr. Rice served under both the Reagan and Bush administrations throughout the 1980s and early 90s. But it was her stint with George W. in the 2000s that finally earned her the prized Secretary of State title. Under Prime Minister Paul Martin, the Civil Marriage Act was introduced to the House of Commons of Canada on the 1st of February 2005.
The people of Canada have worked hard to build a country that opens its doors to include all, regardless of their differences.
The bill effectively legalized gay marriage across the country and started a bit of a trend, since just a few months later, Spain followed in the footsteps of their friends in the Great White North. On the last day of June, the Spanish Parliament voted to equalize gay marriage and eliminate all distinctions between same-sex and heterosexual unions. The campaign for same-sex marriage had actually begun a year earlier under the newly elected Prime Minister José Luis Rodríguez Zapatero, who was able to see his hard work come to fruition and be re-elected in 2008. After years of inquiry on the part of the United States, North Korea publicly confirmed that it does, in fact, possess nuclear weapons. According to a statement made by the state-run Korean Central News Agency, North Korea manufactured nukes for self-defense to cope with the Bush administration's ever more undisguised policy to isolate and stifle the North. In other words, they claimed they were just keeping up with the Joneses. Or would that be Bush's?
Prince Charles and Camilla Parker Bowles announced their engagement this week.
Isn't it joyous? I mean, just look at this vision.
That same day, Charles, Prince of Wales, announced his engagement to the soon-to-be queen consort, Camilla Parker Bowles. After the divorce and eventual untimely death of Princess Diana in the late 90s, the British public speculated on the nature of Charles and Bowles' relationship. You couldn't have chosen a more romantic announcement day, Charles? Valentine's Day was just 4 days away.
So when's the date?
April 8th, and it can't come soon enough. And when she lifts her veil, the entire audience will gasp.
Yes, they won't gasp.
Speaking of which, love must have been in the air on Valentine's Day, because the internet was about to find itself a new main squeeze in a budding website called YouTube.
A lot of people want to go to the website and actually view the video in a player, so...
How much?
Free.
Who's paying for the bandwidth?
Not us.
Founders Steve Chen, Chad Hurley, and Jawed Karim were former employees of PayPal. Although the site went live on the 14th, the first video wouldn't be uploaded for another 2 months. On April 23rd, Jawed Karim uploaded a video to his fledgling video sharing website titled Me at the Zoo, which is exactly what it sounds like. The 19-second clip features Karim standing in front of the elephant enclosure at the San Diego Zoo, talking about how cool it is that elephants have long trunks.
And that's pretty much all there is to say.
So nothing's really changed as far as YouTube videos are concerned.
If your Visa check card's lost or stolen, you're not liable for fraudulent charges.
And all that money will be put back in your checking account. Sheesh.
Signing with a Visa check card is super, super safe.
Steve Fawcett made history the following month after becoming the first person to fly an airplane around the world by himself without stopping to refuel. Fawcett was a fellow of the Royal Geographical Society and the American-based Explorers Club, who liked to sail and fly hot air balloons in addition to being an accomplished pilot.
There's a great romance to flying around the world and doing it faster than anybody else has done it in that medium.
The journey around the world in the Virgin Atlantic Global Flyer, surprisingly, did not take 80 days. It took 67 hours and 2 minutes to complete and spanned a distance of 40,234 kilometers, or about 25,000 miles. Michael Eisner stepped down as the Walt Disney Company CEO after a 21-year tenure. He was succeeded by then-president and COO Bob Iger. Iger would serve as the company's chief executive officer for 15 years until his contract ended in February 2020. He would be replaced by a different Bob, Bob Chapek, but as it turns out, he wasn't done. After an embarrassingly short stint as the head of the company, Bob Chapek stepped down as Disney CEO, and Iger assumed the crown once again, which we assume is just one of those expensive Mickey Mouse hats that they sell at the theme parks.
It's with great sadness that Sherry Schiavo has passed away.
After a cardiac arrest left her with severe brain damage in 1990, Terry Schiavo subsequently spent the next 15 years comatose. In 1998, Schiavo's husband and guardian petitioned to have her feeding tube removed, but was refused by Schiavo's parents, who had the petition struck down.
Please, please save my little girl.
The story sparked controversy once it broke the news and stirred up conversations about consent and guardianship of comatose patients. Schiavo's husband would ultimately win the battle. His wife's feeding tube was removed on March 18, 2005, and she died less than 2 weeks later on March 31st. The Ides of March saw the debut of some major TV shows.
People say I am the best boss. They go, God, we've never worked in a place like this before. You're hilarious. I think that pretty much sums it up. I found it at Spencer Gifts.
If you want orders, follow this one. Kill yourself.
Daleks must survive!
The Daleks have failed! Why don't you finish the job and make the Daleks extinct? Rid the universe of your filth! Why don't you just die?
You would make a good Dalek.
And which brings me to rule number three. If I'm sleeping, don't wake me unless your patient is actually dying. Rule number four, the dying patient better not be dead when I get there. Not only would you have killed someone, you would have woke me for no good reason. We clear? Yes.
You said five rules. That was only four.
Rule number five, when I move, you move.
The month of April started off tragically as Pope John Paul II died, fittingly on the 2nd. Over 4 million people would flock to the Vatican over the course of his funeral and the 9 days of observed mourning by the Catholic Church. The Huffington Post started its life as an online commentary outlet and blog on May 9th. Founded by its namesake Arianna Huffington, Andrew Breitbart, Kenneth Lehrer, and Jonah Peretti, the site aimed to provide an alternative to other news aggregators. After 30 years of persistent mystery, former FBI Assistant Director Mark Felt was revealed as Watergate informant Deep Throat in a Vanity Fair article. As the unidentified Deep Throat, Felt leaked key information which helped shed light on the Watergate scandal during Nixon's presidency. At the age of 95, 3 years after having admitted to his role as Deep Throat, Mark Felt passed away at his home in his sleep. The world watched as a jury in Santa Maria Court in California acquitted Michael Jackson on charges of child molestation.
We, the jury in the above-entitled case,
find the defendant not guilty of a lewd act upon a minor child.
The alleged victim and cancer survivor, Gavin Arvizo, was 13 at the time Jackson had him and his family at his Neverland Ranch estate in Los Olivos, California. The trial took 4 months to complete and was described as a media circus, with many major news outlets choosing to cover it for full 24-hour rolling cycles.
N equals what? Josh?
Today we'll be performing a triple Hoffenrider procedure.
But you've never done that before.
That's okay.
Wouldn't it be nice if there was an easy button for life? Now there's one for your business. Staples.
Flass knows.
He won't talk.
He'll talk to me.
Where were the other drugs going?
I never knew. I don't know. I swear to God.
Swear to me!
In another big win for the internet, Reddit was founded by Steve Huffman and Alexis Ohanian.
And that's the two of us on the first day of Y Combinator. You'll also notice I had a t-shirt with a mascot that I designed long before we actually built a website. That was dumb, wrong order of operations.
Beginning as the two college roommates' side project at the University of Virginia, the online forum is one of the web's most visited sites today. Starting July off right, Pink Floyd's classic lineup reunited one final time to play at Live 8. It had been more than 24 years since frontman Roger Waters, guitarist David Gilmour, drummer Nick Mason, and pianist Rick Wright had taken the stage together. The bandmates put aside years of bad blood to put on the show of a lifetime in front of a crowd of around 200,000 fans. The show became even more meaningful just a few years later when Richard Wright, Pink Floyd's keyboard player, went off to the great gig in the sky in 2008 at just 65 years old.
Reports are just coming in of an explosion at Liverpool Street Station here in London.
The city of London was horrifically targeted by four suicide bombings on the morning of July 7th. Three explosions went off simultaneously in the London Underground at 8:50 a.m.
And then it was just smoke everywhere. In the tunnel, we were trying to close the doors because it was just smoke, we couldn't breathe.
And a fourth later detonated on the upper deck of a bus. All totaled, the attacks took the lives of 52 people and injured hundreds. Similar to the attacks of New York City 4 years earlier, the day has come to be known as 7/7. Across the pond in the Florida Panhandle, Hurricane Dennis made landfall as a Category 3 hurricane on Santa Rosa Island.
Get back! Look over there! It's coming apart!
The storm decimated the area, creating 87 mile per hour winds and producing tornadoes across all of Central Florida. 88 people lost their lives, and the storm caused nearly $4 billion in damages.
Claire's mom just made me grab her Hooters.
Well, snap out of it. What were they like anyway? They look pretty good. Are they real? Are they built for speed or for comfort? Motorboat? You motorboating son of a bitch. You old sailor, you.
What is wrong with you?
The Vietnamese believe in something called comprehensive eating. All of the dishes laid out at once so we can appreciate the appearance and the aroma.
In more rural areas, like the Deep South, the flavors are much more vibrant, much more savory, and the rot gut is much, much meaner.
정말 대견합니다. 두부처럼 하얗게 살라고 다시는 죄 짓지 말란 뜻으로 먹는 겁니다.
After a 36-year-long armed campaign, the Irish Republican Army announced that all units had been ordered to dump arms. While splinter groups continued to fight, formal peace talks with the British government had begun in the late 90s. And by July 28, 2005, the IRA had officially laid down their arms.
I welcome the recognition that the only route to political change lies in exclusively peaceful and democratic means.
Shoot him!
What?
Shoot him!
Charlie, I shot you in your head. I am so sorry.
Is it okay?
No, I'm not okay. He shot me in my head.
It really hurts. I gotta go to a hospital.
No, I'll call an ambulance.
Bro, the hospital's like 3 blocks away. We should just drive him.
I know that, but I don't want to get blood stains all over the interior.
Are you serious?
After a two-day hearing in Wichita, Kansas, serial murderer Dennis Rader was sentenced to 10 consecutive life sentences in prison for the 10 slayings he committed in the 1970s. Known as the BTK killer, Rader would ultimately face down 175 years of jail time.
Do you like to do it yourself?
If the mood strikes.
How is the mood striking you now?
That totally worked. I literally said nothing.
Barely a month after the devastating effects of Hurricane Dennis, Katrina swept over the Gulf Coast as a Category 4 hurricane.
It's extremely hard to leave. Your whole life is here, your whole world, and it's hard to decide what's important and what's of value.
Wind speeds reached up to 145 miles per hour, and torrential rains flooded 80% of the city of New Orleans for weeks. All in all, Katrina killed over 1,000 people and caused over $108 billion in damages.
The destruction of the spirit of the people of southern Louisiana and Mississippi may end up being the most tragic loss of all.
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
Yeah, the other guys are like, starting maybe six man?
Right.
Maybe if six
that,
man.
Right. Rejected! Don't you bring that weak tot action! You go strong to your mouth or you don't go at all!
Game day food. Nothing goes better with sports than Sonic's extra long cheese coney covered with cheese and meaty chili. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
Just 3 days later, a false bomb threat caused a stampede on the Al Ima Bridge in Baghdad. Over 1 million people were gathered around the Al-Qadimiyya Mosque, and countless were packed on the bridge, crossing the Tigris River. The stampede forced countless people across the bridge and killed almost 1,000 of them on impact, through suffocation or by drowning in the river below. After 19 years of service in the Supreme Court, Chief Justice William Rehnquist passed away at the age of 80. Rehnquist was the 16th Chief Justice of the U.S. Supreme Court and was first appointed by Richard Nixon in 1971. A Danish newspaper called Jyllands-Posten made international headlines on the last day of September after publishing several editorial cartoons of the Prophet Muhammad, which was considered controversial to downright blasphemous according to strict Muslim doctrine that forbids visual depictions of the Prophet. Protests and riots broke out the world over, leading to a global conversation about censorship and religious tolerance. Putting an end to the doom and gloom of the summer and early fall of 2005, the NFL kicked off October by playing their first regular game outside the USA.
Important matches in Mexico played there, and you would say, okay, is this actually happening? An NFL professional game is being played here, one that counts.
The Arizona Cardinals beat the San Francisco 49ers 31-14 at Estadio Azteca in Mexico City, and the game boasted 103,467 spectators, the biggest turnout in NFL history at the time. In an event about as important to teenage girls as the first international NFL game was to college kids and middle-aged dads, Stephanie Meyer's first novel in her vampire romance series was published on October 5th. The book, called Twilight, would become a sensation and spawn a series of movies starring Robert Pattinson and Kristen Stewart, an unending cavalcade of merchandise,
Twilight stuff, heck yes,
and countless parodies throughout the years.
Your skin is green, you freak out or on fire.
Say it out loud.
Frankenstein.
3 days later, the Kashmir earthquake hit Pakistan, India, and parts of Afghanistan. At a magnitude of 7.6, the quake devastated the area and demolished over 32,000 buildings. It killed 86,000 people and injured at least 69,000 more.
Greetings, NASA. It's me, Stephen Colbert. And I just want to congratulate you on a great year. Your dramatic pictures from Cassini, finding water on Mars, though I urge you to never give up on President Bush's bold challenge. Before this decade is out, we must launch a probe to find out if there's oil in heaven.
Saddam Hussein, the deposed president of Iraq, was put on trial in Baghdad for crimes against humanity by the Iraqi interim government on October 19th. His charges, including violent campaigns against the Kurds and Shiites, were laid out on the world stage for all to see. For his part, Hussein maintained he wasn't actually deposed at all and was still the legal president of Iraq. We'll find out how well that worked for him in the next episode. Civil rights activist Rosa Parks died due to complications with dementia at the age of 92. In honor of her brave protest in the 1950s, where she refused to give up her seat to white passengers in a segregated bus, all buses in the Montgomery area reserved their front seats with black ribbons until she was laid to rest. In another tragic incident, three suicide bombers made coordinated attacks on local hotels in Amman, Jordan. 60 people lost their lives, and over 100 more were injured in the explosions. A fourth explosion was set, but the would-be bomber's belt failed to detonate, and she was arrested. Gamers rejoiced when the Xbox 360 came out in late November, just in time for the kids to start begging for one for Christmas.
This is my Xbox 360. It's here, And it's on.
Tech giant Microsoft released their most recent video game console alongside games like Call of Duty 2, NBA 2K6, and Perfect Dark Zero. Yeah, remember that one? Bigger and better in every way than its predecessor, the original Xbox, the 360 sold out immediately across North America and Europe and became one of the most revered home consoles ever produced. That same day, Angela Merkel became the first woman ever sworn in as a German chancellor. Following a tight electoral race and 2 weeks of negotiations, Merkel led the country for 13 years and was frequently called the most powerful woman in the world. Ted Koppel also wanted to make his mark on November 22, 2005. The famed late-night television host officially retired from ABC's Nightline after one final show. He had been the program's host since its inception in 1980 and touched on a whole host of important cultural and political topics, even interviewing Nelson Mandela in 1990.
You've always been very nice to me, so give this new anchor team for Nightline a fair break. If you don't, I promise you the network will just put another comedy show in this time slot.
One day later, another political first caught the attention of the masses. Ellen Johnson Sirleaf won in her electoral race against George Weah to become Liberia's president, making her Africa's first democratically elected female head of state and Liberia's first elected leader after 14 years of civil war.
But you didn't want it, Ennis. So what we got now is Brokeback Mountain. And I'm not you. I can't make it on a couple of high-altitude once or twice a year. I wish I knew how to quit you.
Stand-up comedian, writer, and actor Richard Pryor was known for his intimate and subversive work, being heralded by his peers as one of the greatest comics of all time.
This man's a genius. Now who else can take all the forms of comedy, slapstick, satire, mime, and stand-up, and turn it into something that'll offend everyone?
Any comic work in America was influenced by what he's done.
On December 10th, he passed away from a heart attack at his Los Angeles home. But he is survived by a legacy across film and stage that's as relevant today as it was at the height of his career. And with the loss of a comedic legend, 2005 came to a close. Next year, we'll see a similar mix of tragedy and comedy with the death of a beloved Australian zookeeper, the downgrade of Pluto's planet status, the release of a now iconic mockumentary about a man from Kazakhstan, and so much more. Coming soon, 2006.
High five.
So what do you think? What was the biggest moment of 2005? Let us know in the comments below, and while you're at it, check out some of these other fascinating timeline videos.